Good morning, students. In the previous class, we have learnt in detail about the variables. What is variable, how to create a variable, and how to assign value to the variable in different ways. And we have also learnt about the comments. But now, in today's class, we will learn how to print the data in variety of ways with the help of a print function. In Python, we have print as a function, means it is also known as a function, is also known as a method. We have so many methods which Python provides us for our functionality. So whenever we want to print something on the screen, that is on the standard output device, we have to use the function print. How we come to know it is a function? Because it has parenthesis after that. So whenever any word have the parenthesis after that, we should understand that it is a function. It is predefined function with some special meaning. So what we have to do is, whatever value we have to print, it has to be enclosed in the parenthesis of the print function. Now we will learn how we can print function in variety of ways with the help of an example. In this first example, what we are saying is n1 comma n2 is equals to 20 comma 30. This syntax we have learned earlier. In this particular statement, we are creating two variables, n1 and n2. First variable is n1, so 20 will be assigned to the n1. Second variable is n2. And second value is 30. So 30 will be assigned to n2. Now here comes the third variable, that is sum. Sum is equals to n1 plus n2. Now this side, while assigning the value to the sum variable, right hand side we have the expression instead of a constant value. Now we will add up these two numbers, 20 and 30, that is n1 and n2. The value of n1 is 20 and the value of n2 is 30. So 20 plus 30 comes out to be 50. 50 will be assigned to the variable sum. Equal to is known as the assignment operator, which is used to assign right hand side value to the left hand side. Now in the third statement we have the hash symbol. What is hash? Hash is a symbol to give the comment. And what are comments? Just a revision. It is used to increase the readability of the program. It is not itself executing. So comments are non-executable statement. Hardly matters. It will not affect the program. So now next statement is print, and in the parenthesis we have given the value sum. Sum is the name of the variable, and we have not enclosed the sum into the single quotes or the double quotes, so the value of sum will be printed, not sum. When we have to print as it is, then we enclose it into the single quotes or double quotes. But what we want to print the value of sum, that is why it is not enclosed in the single quotes or double quotes. Here in this case it will print the value 50. There is another method also. See the next print statement. Print, in the parenthesis we are giving n1 plus n2. Now in this case we have not taken any temporary variable. We have reduced that statement. Now instead of three statements in a program, we are working only with the two statements. So print n1 plus n2. It will calculate the value first and then display the value 50. Print statement can accept multiple values at the same time. I can print so many values at the same time with the help of one single print statement, but these are to be separated by the comma. Let us see with an example. First, when we write print hello friends, it is taking only one expression, that is one value, and it is enclosed in double quotes, So it will print as it is, "Hello, friends." It is a constant message. In the second statement, to increase the readability, I have given here two expressions. I have placed one comma. We are taking the help of the previous question itself. In the previous question, we did sum is equals to n1 plus n2. So the sum variable was having the value 50. To increase the readability, we are dividing the expression into two parts with the help of the comma in print expression. This time we have written print, the sum is. Now what is the sum is? It is a constant message which we want to print as it is. So that is why it has been enclosed in double quotes. Comma, sum. Now sum is a variable. Variable having the value 50. So what will be the output? The output will be, instead of only 50, what it will print? The sum is 50. So the readability of the program thus increases. Is this thing clear to you? One thing more. Here the variable sum, sum ka S is in capital letters. So be careful, Python is case sensitive. If we have created sum, S is capital letters, so we will be using in the same way as we have created. Here we have to learn something interesting. By default, when we print multiple values with the print statement, the two values are separated by space. So space is the default separator. But specially I want some other character to replace the space. It is possible. The SEP. SEP is the separator used in between the values. It defaults into the space character. We will see with the help of an example. If we write print 10, 20, 30, 40. After that, we have written the comma SEP. SEP is what? It is the separator. And I want to separate these four values 10, 20, 30, 40 with the help of asterisk symbol, not with the help of space. Then whatever character I will write in the single quotes or the double quotes, both are allowed. If I separate it with the at the rate, the output will be 10, at the rate 20, at the rate 30, at the rate 40. I can give with the dollar sign, percentage sign, any special character I want to give, I can use here with the separator. So whatever character we give to the SEP in single quotes or double quotes, that separator will replace the default space.